Hey guys, Mike Majette, PGA professional and your selfie golf coach. Let's talk about how to hit various shots out of the rough when you're around the green. Okay, beautiful thing about golf is that it throws you all sorts of challenges. A couple of challenges we have are around the green. Okay, when we're in the rough, we are faced with a number of different lies. Now, one may look really good when the ball is sitting right on top of the grass, looks like it's teed up. The most common mistake I see in anybody's short game is to get the club down, hit the bottom of the grass, and the ball comes off the top of the club face. Comes off dead, doesn't reach our target. We don't want that. So, what do we do to fix this? I have a 60 degree lob wedge. So I'll rehearse a swing where I'm just grazing the top of the blades of grass. Okay? And when I feel ready, line the ball back with the back foot, make the same swing. Okay? It's gonna come out with some loft, it's gonna come out with some pop. You'll actually reach your target. You won't be chipping again. You won't have to deal with all the grass if you get to the bottom. So, what happens when we have the complete opposite lie? The ball is buried, looks like it's sitting down, there's a lot of grass behind the golf ball. Well, our number one task is to minimize the amount of grass that comes in between the face and the golf ball. How do we do that? Well, the things I'm gonna keep the same are my ball position, so it's a little further back, and my weight. I'm always on my left side when I'm hitting a short shot. So weight forward, ball even with my back foot. Now, if you noticed how wide I was when I was picking the ball off the tops of the blades of grass. I'm gonna be a little bit steeper. This is gonna be almost like a pop stroke. I'm gonna feel like I'm dropping the club on the golf ball. There's not gonna be much of a follow through. Get it out. Okay, again, we are minimizing the amount of grass that comes between the face and the golf ball. Okay, that's what you need to get the ball out, rolling on the green. Okay, if you have a short-sided shot with this, please, 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 and by short-sided, I mean you don't have a lot of green to work with, please just worry about getting the ball out and on the green. Okay, I preach this all the time. I'd rather take a 10 to 15 footer for par than to be chipping again. Correct? You're gonna save some shots. If your number one goal get the ball out of whatever lie you have and on the green. Okay, just focus on that, and I promise you'll drop the score. Do this one more time. Ball buried. Weight forward. Ball back in my hand. Pop it up. Okay? So, practice these shots in variations. What I want you to do is to grab 5, 6, 7 golf balls, doesn't matter how many. Throw them around your practice green. Okay? Then try to get them up and down one by one. Don't go around and hit all the shots. Hit a pitch, make a putt. If you don't, you're plus one. If you do, you're even more. If you chip in, you're one under. Keep track of that. Keep the amount of golf ball that you use consistent. You have sort of a benchmark to work off. So let's go with 7 to 9 golf balls. Keep it in there. Try to get them up and down. Track your score. Okay, I hope these tips help you get out of certain lies around the green.